morning and welcome to our Midweek Manna on this Wednesday, September the 27th at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern. All this month we've been talking about the seven habits to grow spiritually. And so today is habit number seven, and I want to go back and review the other ones that we've had so far. So today is be refilled with the Holy Spirit. You know, there are times in our lives when we just feel depleted. So many things going on, situations, relationships, circumstances, all these things go on. And sometimes we just need the Holy Spirit that Jesus left for us when he ascended to heaven to refill us, to give us the strength to continue to do the things that God has called each one of us to do. And that's okay to get tired. You know, we're not super people. We're not superhuman. And sometimes we just need that extra oomph to get us over over the hump, so to speak, to make it through. So that's number seven. So I want to go back and review the other ones. And if you like, please feel free to go back and look at the other videos as well. But habit number one was to spend time with God each morning. See, when we get up in the morning, some of us feel refreshed and just ready to start our day. I challenge you, before you get into your day, that you spend just some time with God. It doesn't have to be a long time. Just make it consistent, whether it's 4 minutes or 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Just make sure you do that on a daily basis, and you'll be surprised how much peace you begin to have. The second one is to feed your spirit with other sources. You know, some people don't like us to read things outside the Bible, but unless we take the time to read historical books, even books that help elevate our spirituality, it kind of like not help us grow as a spiritual being. So I would challenge you to find things like Max Lucado is a wonderful author of many books out there. I just read a book by Mitch Ambrum that is absolutely wonderful. You will not figure out what's going on at all until the very last page, which is a great book to. It was just good when books are like that. Number three was spend time in quiet. And I know this is a challenge for many people who are not introverts like me, but just spend time in stillness, in quiet, just to sit. There's so much noise and chaos that go on around us in our world today that sometimes we feel like we just don't have time to ourselves. We don't have time to ourselves because we don't make time for ourselves. In the bathroom is quiet. In a closet is quiet. Maybe sitting in your car before you walk into your job, or sitting in your car before you walk into the house. All of those moments can be quietness. Just sitting. Not doing anything, just sitting. The next one we talked about was spending time with others who strengthen you. Again, we can read the Bible all day long. We memorize scripture all day long. But unless we put it into action, we really don't know if we have grown stronger or not. When people come to us and they want us to pray for them, or asking for a scripture or something, if we're not already involved with the scripture, involved with the Holy Spirit, we will not have anything to give to them. We will not know how to pray. And so I challenge you to make sure that you spend time with others who strengthen you and challenge you. Acknowledge God throughout the day. I know sometimes we can say thank you, Jesus, and thank God, but do you really make time to be intentional about the time that you acknowledge God? You know, just kind of slow down, not just praise God, but thank God for the job. Thank God for keeping you from the accident that happened. If you had left 5 minutes earlier or 5 minutes later, that you would have been involved in. Those are the moments that we need to acknowledge God and God's presence. And last week was say no to things that you should not do. Many people challenge with this. I shared this at a retreat this past week about the fact that 85% of what we do, others can do. 10% of what we do, we can train other people to do. And 5% of what we do is what we should do. And too many times we focus on the 85 and not the 5. What if we challenge? What if we focus on the 5% and allow other people to do the 95%? I wonder what our lives would look like. So those are your seven habits to grow spiritually strong every day. Incorporate those things into your life every day. And I guarantee you that you will find yourself growing stronger and stronger in Christ. Thank you for listening. I pray that something that I've said or shared this day will indeed bless you. Take care. Bye-bye.